Welcome back, everyone. We are inside the house I built last episode. Well, certainly the exterior. We're going to work on the inside now. And I've basically just started with the floor, turned the grass into planks. It matches the ceiling. I'm not sure if I like that, but it was a choice between this or... Well, I mean, we could do cobble, could do glass. Wool... Nah. I would have done wool if you could have got different colours, but it's only white. We could have done stone slabs, but I wasn't so sure about that either, so I just went for the standard wooden planks, and it does match the roof, but I can live with it, especially given the fact there's very few other blocks in the game. Beyond that, I don't really have much of an idea. I've decided I'm not going to make different rooms because it's going to be difficult to separate them, and it may detract from the build itself. Like, if I try to build up walls and kind of make different compartment areas in that for rooms, I feel like that would not look so good. So what we're going to do is we're going to have an open feel to the house, and we're going to have possibly some upstairs, but it's all going to be held within this one room, and I think that's okay. I think we can get away with that. As you can see, I'm just creating a bit of a walkway here, dividing the central walkway from the outer areas using wooden logs. And the good thing about using planks is obviously there's stair variants and all that sort of stuff. But my plan, I should say, for the coming episodes, if I can get around to it, is to hopefully get started or get restarted on some of the builds that I have not finished. Things that I've kind of left by the wayside. So things like the village in and around the... Oh, we're out of logs, that's annoying. The village in and around the mob system tower. The area around the arena. Part of the reason I've not worked on the arena or the area around it is because it's very challenging to get to. Like, if the nether was around, no problem, I could easily just walk it. But the thing is, you've got to walk it in the overworld. There's no direct transport system. In fact, you know, let's start on the staircase. Yeah, there's no direct transport system that goes to it. The closest thing you can use is the... Well, there's a rail track that takes you to the excess storage room by the skeleton spawner. The other way is just take the each road to the tower and then walk the rest of the way, so there's really no good way there. Is that an oversight on my part? Not really. I mean, the reason I built the arena there was because of the zombie spawner is there, and that's kind of what it revolves around. So I don't regret building it there. It's obviously just a pain to get to work on. Ideally, I want to work on and finish as many things as possible before the terrain update. Otherwise, well, you know, just so that it's all done and we can see it in this traditional Minecraft look before the biomes come out. Because as I've said before, there's going to come a time when the grass outside is no longer going to be green. It most likely will be, you know, yellow or, you know, the colour of Extreme Hills biomes in the contemporary versions. Which I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that. It's just, you know, the light green look of Minecraft is a very... It's unique, and everything might look that wee bit different if the grass colour changes drastically. I'm trying to remember what other biomes there are. I like the colour of the forest biomes, but I think, well, there's forest, there's a savanna/Sahel type biome, there is obviously deserts. I've got some ideas for the deserts, actually. There's, what else is there? Trying to think. I'm sure there's one or two other ones. Forest. I think there's a plains or a... What do you call it? Not plains. Prairie. I think there's a prairie biome. The biome names are different, but they're very similar to like modern versions. So, and the thing is, in my progress world, my progress game back in the day, I liked the bright green grass, but then when the... When I upgraded to the Alpha update, Alpha 1.2, the Halloween update, the grass changed from light green to the Extreme Hills colour of grass, kind of teal, which wasn't a huge issue, But obviously, it did make the world look that wee bit different. Are we high enough yet? I think we'll have to go up a wee bit more. One more, maybe. But yeah, I'm going to make another staircase over the other side, and we'll see how that looks. I might get rid of it if I don't like it, but so far I'm liking how it's looking. But yeah, those are my plans for the coming episodes, and hopefully we can accomplish a lot in them. So I've completed the staircases and the upper floors. I'll show you how that looks from up here. As you can see, I put a bit of a curve on it. The curve isn't great. I did. It's more guesswork, to be honest, but I like the way it looks, and I think the fact it's not a curve, like an exact curve, actually makes it look better. I don't know why. It's more of an oval shape, I guess. We're just gonna add fences here. Fences might take away from the look of it, but at the same time, I kind of want some sort of a railing, an actual barrier there, to prevent anyone being myself, from falling off or jumping over or whatever. There we go. Just adds a bit more of a structure to the house, and we're actually almost out of fences. I was actually gonna add fences here too, but they still don't join up with the blocks at the side, which is yeah, a tad annoying. But there you go, it's what you get for playing in older versions. And as you saw previously, or as you saw previously in this episode, I moved all the chests into this room. We don't have too many more sticks, which is unfortunate, but that should hopefully be enough with regards to fences. So one of the other big challenges we're going to face is lighting. I don't know how we're going to do that. We're going to have to figure out an efficient way of making sure that no mobs spawn. We can't use slabs because I've already laid the floor down, and the only slabs that we have are the stone ones. So we're going to have to, yeah, just scatter torches around. Lava's a no-go because obviously this build is well, partially logs, partially planks, and partially wool, all of which I believe burn. I'm not sure. I'm not sure about wool, and I'm not sure how quick fire spreads, but it's certainly something that we've got to consider. But yeah, it would be really, really daft to try to use lava lighting. So we're going to use torches. I don't know if everyone's a fan of torches. I actually don't mind them, but I understand in some cases it's better to try and go for some less obvious source of light. Anyway, there we go. Fences are up. It looks all right, I think. Obviously, beds don't exist, so we can't exactly put one of those down. I mean, we could like maybe create a bed or something, but yeah, whatever. We'll just have to live with what we can do via aesthetic decoration. I'm going to try to create a sort of a bed area. The only wool we've got is white, unfortunately. We don't have any dyes as of yet, so we're going to have to, yeah, think outside the box, which I'm not very good at doing, but we'll see what we can do. So, I've got a crafting table here, which we'll no doubt put somewhere in the vicinity of the bed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. I know I said that I wasn't going to do stuff. Well, I might have cut that part out of last episode, but I did say something along the lines of I don't want to do stuff that is, seemingly pointless. But I'm just going to go with it. We'll do this because why not? One of the things I really don't like in real life is short beds. I have had bad experiences being. I'm not like super tall, but I'm taller than average. And I can only imagine what it's like for, really tall people having feet stick out the end of beds. Or even worse, when I was in Ireland, 1 year, there was a bed that had like a backboard, which is kind of what we're going to try now. Yeah, the bed had a backboard, and so it kind of, your feet got crushed against it, which was really, really annoying. Let's get the workbench down. But yeah, small beds are something that really annoys me. Right. Don't know why that's like that. That's kind of annoying. Oh, maybe it's because there's a. I bet it's because there's a stair up there. Yeah, it's because there's a stair up there. We might have to, yeah, reevaluate what we're doing here with regards to the backboard. That looks marginally better. Just marginally. You know me, you know that my intricate design skills are not the best. I mean, I think it looks okay. I saw an image of a modern kind of bed in Minecraft, and it was quite cool because it was like they'd used snow, the snow layers, to create a pillow, which was looked really good. But obviously, we do not have access to that. We don't even have access to carpets. We're actually going to use another one of these just for symmetry's sake. I'm not symmetry mad, but it's always nice to create a bit of symmetry. Yeah, we've got to stick torches around at every possible opportunity. I'm probably just going to, yeah, divvy torches on every single post that I can find. That's part of the problem. Loads of mobs spawned in here when there was no lights. I was it at night time? I don't remember if it was at night time or daytime. It was probably in daytime, which obviously makes sense. But you just don't want mobs spawning indoors. That's not the purpose for which this is built. It's not built for the mobs. It's built for me and whoever I decide to rent it out to. I was thinking of doing a fireplace, but like, where would I do a fireplace? Where would I put it? Also, I've already spoken about fire and lava and how putting it in this area would not be good. Right, I'm just trying to figure out what to do for the front porch bit. I think I'm going to end up just putting stairs down. I was going to put slabs down, but I think stairs would make more sense. This is going to be like the front entrance. We should put some logs down as well. You kind of beat a few logs next to stairs. Maybe we should use another block as opposed to logs. Maybe stone or maybe stone slabs, such as the ones I've got in my inventory. Just for something a bit different, and also to save logs. And it's going to come from over there. We're going to create a walkway from the station, or the airport, whatever you want to call it, to airport. I mean airport, technically I'm travelling in the air when I come here, so it's perfectly plausible to define that area as an airport. Anyway, oh come on. Right, there we go. Yeah, I don't want to die. I absolutely do not want to die. Just go behind that pillar, please. If I die, it's a long. Oh, that was so close. I'm just gonna leave him. Problem is, I can't leave him. He'll follow me out. I don't really want to be followed out. Oh no. I'm gonna die. Help! Help! There we go. Right. He shouldn't get us now. We should be good. There we go. Whoa! And my spade's broke. The good thing is, though, I did craft an absolute ton when I was digging out the floor earlier, so we shouldn't be lacking. Anyway, I was working on a bit of a path from the airport to my house, as you can see. It's not that great, but it'll do the job. And it does go under this hill, kind of. Well, not kind of, it does. It does go under the hill, through the hill, whatever you want to call it. I don't know, it looks okay. Well, I'm going to change out all of this with stone, I reckon. I might add some paintings or something on the side, just for decoration. I'll be honest, I wasn't going to mention this, but I was thinking of turning this into like a kind of customs area. You know, where you, at an airport, where you go and get searched and everything. Not that I enjoy that part, but you know what I mean? It's like an integral part of airports and things like that. So I just thought, well, I might add that. But then I was disheartened because I went online and I looked up airports, Minecraft, and all of the builds were spectacular and substantial in size. And so I'm like, well, I can't really justify having just a single corridor as an airport. So I think we'll give up on that idea. Who knows? Maybe I'll build an airport another time or another place or whatnot. So I was going to say, I was actually playing a lot on the PS2 this week, something I've not done for many a year. I actually managed to complete Ratchet and Clank 3, something I never managed in my youth. But let's be honest, I'm a lot better at video games now than in my youth. So yeah, and I managed to complete that, which was fun. Also, I figured out I actually have the original Battlefront, Star Wars Battlefront, on the PS2. The PS2, I mentioned a few episodes ago, I got the PS2 from a random guy. Okay, it wasn't a random guy, but from someone who I wouldn't have expected to. I got it from him back in like 2013. It also came with a bunch of games. And the thing is, I remembered all the games I had when I was younger, but I didn't remember these games that he'd given me, because obviously I'd barely played them. So yeah, I was surprised to find Battlefront, the original Battlefront, was amongst them. So that was pretty fun. I'm just no good at it. It's one of these ones that I feel like in certain situations, or maybe it's not even just me, maybe in general, like for example handheld games, maybe they're easier than console games. I'm not sure if you would necessarily class, like for example the Nintendo Wii, I'm not sure you would class that as a console. I've not played much on the Nintendo Wii in my life, but whenever I do Mario Kart, for example, I always seem to do badly at it on the Wii. However, on the old Nintendo DS Lite, I was unbelievable at it. I could do it hard as difficulty and all that. So I mean, either I'm just better at handheld games, or maybe it's a case of, let's just dig down here. We're gonna add in some stone here, or maybe it's just generally accepted that handheld games are easier than Wii games, console games, whatever you want to call them. But that's just something interesting I was thinking about. Alright, we're going to have to like reshape the hill a bit. I don't have much in the way of dirt, unfortunately, because I already put it away. But if we do something like this, we should be alright. Just kind of shape the hill as best as we can, just to make it look natural. Does Minecraft exist for the Wii? I know Minecraft no longer exists for like the PS3 and all that. I know it was those versions were discontinued, but I wonder if Minecraft exists for the Wii. I really wouldn't know. I've never played console. I've only briefly seen Windows 10 edition, because I believe Domo has it, and I've only played mobile version like once or twice, and it's good. Like I definitely appreciate those versions and the fact that Minecraft can be played on all different sorts of systems, but obviously it's just Java edition is just what I've always played, so that's kind of what I'm used to. Right, we're going to add one or two other rooms in the house. I think we're going to add a bit of a storage room. The problem is all my chests are here and I want them to be somewhere else. I think the storage room or storage area is going to be downstairs. So we'll just make a bunch of chests, and we'll put the storage area over here. Why not? Right, this is evidently how we're going to have to do it. I think what we'll do is we're going to use logs, I reckon, for the corner parts. I think that's what we'll do. That'll be best. If I can just get in here, and yeah, that'll be fine. I reckon that could work. Oh, except, yeah, the chests are going to face a different way. Yeah, well, not much I can do about that. Not my problem. Said anyone that's annoyed by it, that's their problem. Alright, so I've just added some lighting and some paintings to this tunnel. Of course, we've got the skylight here, which looks pretty neat. And some trees have grown, and they've started to have their leaves despawn, which is really annoying. But don't worry, it gets even more annoying next update, where leaves don't despawn at all, no matter how much of the tree you have chopped. Inside this house, I have obviously, as I said, I've worked on the bed, the best alpha bed I could come up with. Unfortunately, sleeping in it doesn't actually work. I've also worked on a bit of a storage area down here. Again, as I was building this, thoughts were going through my head about just how much I was actually going to use this, and I think in time I might use it a bit, depending on how much we explore that way in terms of the new terrain. So yeah, there's that to possibly think about, but I'm not convinced I'll spend as much time here as I will in my other base, because obviously the other base is all the farms and most of my materials and that. I had to actually transport the materials to build this from far and wide, which it was okay, but it's just a bit of a pain because obviously no shulker boxes, no ender chests, nothing of that sort. But yeah, my point of saying that is as time goes on, we'll add more and more to this place. You know, for example, if I'm playing this and I get to the version where beds are added, then we can add beds. It's just a variety of stuff we could think about adding. But with that said and done, I will see you next time.